another wonderful morning. I love being Abel, brother of Cain, son of Adam and Eve, and I'm on my way to go feed my chickens.
Who's that? Who's that voice?
Well, I'm the narrator. I'm telling the story. I'm your inner thoughts.
Well, that doesn't sound anything like me. Can you try a different voice?
I could try. How about this?
Yeah, that's more like it.
And I'm on my way to go feed chickens. I'm getting chickens ready for food, but I will also be sacrificing them. My brother will also be bringing vegetables to the sacrifice. I hope my chickens grow up big and fat. I think I'll take my staff and walk away.
Oh, who's that off in the distance? What is that? Oh, it's my brother, Cain. Cain, how are our vegetables in the garden? Do you have enough to feed the family? Cain, how are mother and father? Are they well? Oh, well, it sure is a good day to be alive.
That's a good day to be dead, too! Gotcha! Now what?
What? What's the problem?
As the director of this film, I'm trying to deliver a premium video for these kids about the story of Cain and Abel. And you two are obviously not doing a good job.
Well, I killed him.
Did you even read the script?
Yeah, we went through it this morning. Cain kills Abel, boom, paychecks, we're on our way, right?
Let me do the honor of reading it for you. At harvest time, Cain brought to the Lord a gift of his farm produce, while Abel brought several choice lambs from the best of his flock. The Lord accepted Abel and his offering, but he did not accept Cain and his offering.
Oh, right, the offering thing. Yeah, I remember that. Yeah, sorry about that. Give us five. I'm going to go catch a lunch, and we'll get right back at it. All right?
Hey,
don't worry about it.
Did you ever get that shrimp tray, man? Because I am starving. I hope so.
We have a video to film.
I am awesome guy rain from heaven above with wisdom power. You may enter.
I have brought you the offering from my garden. Tomatoes, peppers.
Not like vegetables, Cain.
What? But they're good for you. They have plenty of vitamins.
I don't like vegetables, Cain.
I don't know what else to bring.
Hector!
God!
What is this? What's up?
Yo, I just hit a party shop. I got you some Pop Tarts. I need some Capri Sun. That's an offering. What did Cain bring? Vegetables?
I'm out of here.
Vegetables? Are you kidding me? You know he doesn't like vegetables.
But they're good for
you.
Come on,
leave Pop-Tarts and Capri Sun. That's where it's at.
Leave me alone.
Where is that? You know what
I'm saying? I'm not sure.
Hey, you ain't done anything else. Cain kills Abel, we did it just
you
like
you have everything completely backwards.
Oh man, we put our heart into that.
Capri Sun, Pop-Tarts, yeah. Really? God accepts Capri Sun and Pop-Tarts.
I would.
When they're not even invented yet.
I like them.
And vegetables. God hates vegetables now all of a sudden.
Well, yeah, obviously. Everyone does.
Obviously, you two did not read the script again.
No, I gotta be honest, I didn't.
We kinda got what you said.
Yeah.
Just kinda went with it, man.
What really happened?
It was our interpretation.
It was a bad interpretation. What really happened is God accepts Abel's choice offerings of the lambs, but he does not accept Cain's offering of the vegetables.
because they were not the choicest vegetables, and Cain also didn't do it with a good heart, as Abel did.
I see. God saw through the offering. He saw the person's intentions behind it. Is that what you're telling me?
Exactly.
That makes sense, I guess, for God. No.
Adds a little more depth to our character.
And there's also no slapping in the death scene.
I just got carried away. Sorry about that.
Let's see what
I got. I got it. Yeah, that's mine. Coming up.
Enter.
God. Yeah, I just finished attending my flock in the field. I was a shepherd, as you know, and this was the first and the best of my whole flock, and I wanted to make sure it went to you before I took any for myself, so this is my offering to you.
You have done very well, Abel, in your offering. You may go now in peace and be blessed.
Thank you so much.
Answer.
God, I brought you some delicious vegetables. Of course, some of them are slightly damaged because I had to take the better of them for my family, but you may have what is left.
Cain, your offering is not heartfelt like Abel was. These are not the choicest of vegetables. And so I reject your offering, and how you react now will determine whether or not your life is destroyed by sin.
Sounds fair. Can I talk to you outside for a moment, brother?
Yeah, of course, Cain, yes.
Let's please.
Let's straighten this out. Cain, where have you been?
Outside, walking around.
Outside.
Yeah, in my garden.
And what of your brother Abel? Where is he?
Oh, how am I supposed to know? Am I my brother's keeper?
Cain, can you not even admit to what you've done?
Okay, well let me know what you find.
Cain, I know what you did.
I didn't do anything, I was just walking around.
The ground, it cries out from your brother's blood that you spilled.
No.
You killed your brother.
No one saw that. No one knows.
Cain, I know everything.
It's not possible. It's not possible!
As a result, the punishment for what you've done?
No.
You must go to bed without eating ice cream.
No! No, not my ice cream! No!
You may not play any video games.
No!
Now, go to your room and think about what you did.
Again.
We got it all.
Except for the punishments.
We did the punishments.
I know that is the wrong punishment. Let me just help you out. Now you are under a curse and driven from the ground, which opened its mouth to receive your brother's blood from your hand. When you work the ground, it will no longer yield its crops for you. You will be a restless wanderer on the earth.
That sounds pretty bad.
It's worse than ice cream.
Yeah. He was driven from his homeland. He couldn't. His land wouldn't produce crops.
Wouldn't grow anymore.
And he was forced to be a wanderer. The rest of his life, he had to be a wanderer.
Yep. The rest of his life.
Wow.
Okay.
I guess it's worse than video games, ice cream.
Yeah. That's way worse. Yeah.
All right. No, I promise. We got this time.
From the top.
No.
Cain, I know what you did.
No.
I saw.
There was no one there. It's impossible. No one saw.
Cain, I'm always there.
No.
Cain, as punishment for what you've done, the way you responded to my rejection of your offering.
No, please.
You are hereby banished from the land you live in.
No.
The ground.
No.
Will no longer yield abundant crops for you and your family.
No.
And you are forced to be a wanderer the rest of your days.
No.
Now go.
This punishment is too great for me to bear.